This is Charlie, SwordSurvival.com. Welcome back. In this segment, I'm going to cover some field first aid. The antidote I'm going to use. This is Charlie, SwordSurvival.com. Welcome back. On this episode, I'm going to cover some field first aid techniques. And the technique I'm going to use is charcoal. Using charcoal to treat yourself. So I got some charcoal set up here. I'm gonna go ahead and set up the camera and prepare it for you and explain to you how you're gonna use it for your benefit. Okay, so up here I have some wood charcoal that I prepared that you normally would find in your fireplace out in a survival situation or any other time. You want pieces about this big that you can grind up. The wood that you use can't be a poisonous wood, okay, because it'll defeat the purpose of using it, because you'll just poison yourself with it. But what you want with this charcoal is when you feel that you got food poisoning, or you ate something that was poisonous, or you have real bad diarrhea, stomach cramps, you can use charcoal, kind of like a Pepto-Bismol or something in that nature. But the charcoal has great properties in absorbing five times or more its density in toxins. And this will help if you have something in your stomach that's irritating that causes you to throw up or real bad diarrhea. This will help absorb whatever's in there and get it out quicker. Now, you'll probably throw this up, which is part of the purpose, is once it absorbs itself, the body is going to purge itself of this charcoal and take it along with it, whatever might be upsetting your stomach. It tastes nasty, yeah, but if you want to survive, you want to feel better, then this is something you need to do. You're going to need 1 ounce charcoal powder every 4 to 5 hours as your symptoms persist. So basically what you do is get what you believe is 1 ounce full, get you something that you can crush up with into a powder. I'm using a plastic lid here, but of course it's better if you do it on a rock or somewhere flat. I'm doing it here so I can see it on camera. But what you want to do is get it to a real fine powder. And if I quit losing half of it, you sit there, you grind it up. I'm not going to make a full dose of it, but you'll get the idea. But the large chunks, you don't want any large chunks. You want as powdery as you can get it. I'm going to put it down here so I can work a little bit better. Basically, you want to get it into as fine as far as you can get it, and then put it in another container. I'm only making probably a third of the dose. And then you'll get water. When you mix the water in it, you don't want to put too much water. Because you want it kind of like a gravy consistency when you drink it. Here, so I'll transfer all that over here. don't know if you can see this on camera, but it looks kind of thick, not too watery, because you want it to be able to absorb, but you don't really want a large chunks in there. Anything large you need to take out. And then I'm doing this kind of fast, so it's not the way I would do it if I was actually going to use it, but you get the idea. But crush that really fine, like cocoa powder, and then drink that 1 ounce every 4 to 5 hours as the system persists, and I wouldn't take it no more than 2 days. Then again, use this at your own risk. I'm not a doctor. I've seen it used, and it's the military uses the same concept. So if they're right, I got to be right, or somewhere in between. But anyway, charcoal is a good use for toxins, because it's used in biological masks, filters, and all kind of stuff. But again, make sure the wood that you're using from your fireplace, your campfire, whatever, is not a poisonous wood, because all you'll do is just be making yourself worse. So here's a good idea that you may want to try if you're getting those very, very bad stomach pains and can't control your bowel movements and things like that. You may have some kind of something in your stomach causing it, and this may be able to absorb it and get it out of your system. So there you go. There's a survival tip on the use of charcoal for medicinal purposes while you're surviving. If I can keep my camera straight. Cameraman's not here again today. But hopefully it'll help you if you ever need it. This is Charlie. Stay prepared, stay alive, and come back soon.